guys, it's me, Trachea. Warriors, welcome back to my channel. So, first of all, I wanted to thank everybody that tuned in after what, the video yesterday, last week. My nerves are going already, so you guys can already tell. I want to thank everybody that came to comfort me, to just, like, tell me that everything is gonna be okay. I have total faith in my surgeon. My doctor has been with me for 3 years, and he's a really good doctor. And he says it's time. So, I've been trying to push this off because, you know, I was so excited to get the laryngectomy. Well, it was a surgery with the cartilage because it was less invasive. I was so happy to get that one. But when he told me that, no, we can't do this, we need major surgery, it was like, it was so heartbreaking, because I was so scared of this resection surgery because of my situation and the fact that I scarred so badly. I didn't want to do this and then have a chance of re-scarring, and then that's it. Even though, yes, I will have to drink for life, it's just the fact that if I re-scar, then can't talk no more, and then don't get the chance anymore. It's like, right now, there's a chance. Afterwards, there's no chance. No chance whatsoever. I will have the electrolaryngs for life. Now, don't get me wrong. I have made my name off of having my electrolaryngs. To the point of decorating my electrolaryngs. Now, I am not scared and I am not, like, broken hearted if I have to have my electrolaryngs. It's just, like anything, when you lose something, you lose something. You have to go through that grieving process. And that's just it. I will have to go through that breathing process, and I'm not prepare for it. On another tip, jury alert. Now, usually I wear my jury without this part. Now, for the fact that my doctor specifically said that he do not want me to accidentally decalculate myself, I decided to keep this one on. Now on my jury that I have made, I am confident with it that it won't do anything to decalculate myself. But because this is a new jury, I always have to try my jury before I even offer it to anybody. Lately, I haven't been selling my jury only because, I don't know, some people don't understand my style, and, I like to, you know, do designs that kind of, like, matches me. So, I am loving this, but I am wearing this for safety. I'm gonna sleep in for tonight to see, like, how sturdy. It's pretty sturdy. Yeah, I mean, even rolling it like that, it's like wiggling my drink and it's making me cough. But this right here is pretty thick, so I doubt that it would break or, you know, accidentally decalculate, but I have to be 100% sure. basically the state that I'm in right now, where they like, if you decagulate yourself, it's a possibility that we won't be able to place it in. And that's all I need to hear. It would not be coming out. It would not be coming out. On another note, I think my Wagner is flaring up. My eye on this side just got all of a sudden puffy. I'm getting rashes. And, yeah. I also got my bumps that's warming underneath my mouth palate that hurts really bad. So, I actually believe it's because of my stress level. It's just like, to the top. I want to personally thank Bill Peterson and Katrina Stuckey for like coming into my box and coming to my my comments and telling me, you know, about the keto. If you guys know, I did do keto back when it didn't stop for some reason, because I just didn't understand it. I want to thank Miss Stuckey for like saying that she's gonna help me with it. Because if I go on with this bariatric, I gotta lose weight regardless. So I'm gonna need all the help that I'm gonna need. Also, Theo Peterson for like, you know, just motivating me, being that warrior, motivating me that, you know, everything is gonna be okay. Because even though, you know, we go through these situations, when something new happens, you seem to always, like, take a step back and have to breathe, like, okay? And you have to kind of, like, get yourself, you know, you need the help. I need the help, and I believe other people need the help. And if you're watching this and you need the help, you got this. You got this. Anything is possible. If I can do it, you can do it. We got this together. Regardless of whatever situation you're going through, you are a fighter. You are a fighter. Don't give up. Don't give up. I'm not giving up. And, you know, I want to thank all my warriors for just keeping me sane, because you can't lose your sanity, you know? And so I'm gonna be that voice. Don't lose your sanity. You got this.
1 week later.
Hey guys, I'm back. And we got a date, guys. We got a date. I am so nervous. But I trust God, and I also trust my surgeon. And I got all my warriors backing me. That's there to like support me, and I'm like, let's go. So my surgery is February 8th. I received the call, and they set up the pre-op appointment. They set up the COVID test. I gotta get a COVID test. They set up, well, the post-op appointment isn't set up, but I'm supposed to be there for 10 days. Supposedly, depending on how my recovery go. And so, there we go, February 8th, guys, from February the 8th, it is around the corner, it is coming. So, I am scared, but yet, like, I got my husband here, and, you know, my kids, they are supporting me and cheering me on. I got a cheerleader, man. I got a cheerleader of people. Oh my God, I ain't never thought I was gonna say that.